kick it. He will kick it. You know he will. He wants to send attention, even in the section, you know, with the mental state he's in just now. But that's a big, because he's been trying all the way through it.
Oh, yeah. Really interesting moment now, because the referee is standing between those two protagonists, the two captains, of course, Ronaldo for Portugal and Jan Oblak as well. Referee's just pointed to our left. That means, I think, the penalties will be taken in front of the Portuguese fans, away from the Slovenian fans, away to our right. We now just have to wait and see, Pat, who's going first.
Yeah, Cristiano Ronaldo's done one very good thing. He's won the toss. Yeah. He's obviously went to go and play against shooting to his own fans from the other side there. That's an advantage, but then again, Ronaldo's messed up that side. And Oblak still on the goals.
And just before they take them, the other thing that just is relevant to this is that the Slovenian head coach had to stay in the stands.
Yeah.
For all of those discussions and pep talks and penalty order, he was in the stand.
Yeah, and they've got the one thing, I suppose, they might have made that list beforehand, but they wouldn't be stayed the same way because so many changes, so many substitutions. So, you know, the old assistants down there will have to make some big decisions. However, here we are, it's just about to start.
It's a classic major tournament scene, packed stadium. Fans can barely watch. Josip Iličić will take first. Hugely experienced player for Slovenia with his left foot. Such a sweet left foot. Here he comes straight into it. Iličić. Oh, brilliant save! Diogo Costa starts this shootout with a bang. He does an Oblak. Not quite as good as Oblak's save. Gets the right way and gets both hands to it. Slovenia have missed their first penalty.
Very similar. Very, very similar to Cristiano Ronaldo's one. They will check to see if he's on the line. They may check every one of these now, but that looked pretty good to me. And I said he'd go to one. He has gone to number one.
Here he comes. CR7, Cristiano Ronaldo. Captain's armband wrapped tightly around his left bicep. Kisses the ball. Wipes it 2-3 times on the penalty spot. Jan Oblak denied him with a save that was out of this world in extra time. It's exactly the same run-up from Ronaldo. Deep breath. Here's the moment. Ronaldo just pauses and then scores. Finds the bottom corner. He goes the other way. Fabulous penalty. Redemption for now. Portugal leading the shootout 1-0.
Oh, you need some bottle to do that. I don't think we question that about Ronaldo generally, but to take a completely different stop and goes to the other corner and nailed, but this time curling away from the goalkeeper, which made all the difference. Did the keeper win the right way again?
So, both teams have taken one penalty apiece. Slovenia missed theirs, Ronaldo has scored his. This is the left back, Jure Balkovic, who goes next for Slovenia. His bright white kick pauses, comes to the ball, and strokes it. Costa's done it again! The hero for Portugal right now, the Portuguese subs are almost tearing onto the pitch. They've got to get back off the pitch as well. He's saved 2 out of 2. Fabulous stuff from Diogo Costa.
Brilliant, brilliant save again. Need to check to see if he's off the line, but yeah, he knows what he's doing. That's a brilliant, brilliant save. Guess straight twice, but you need to do more than guess. You need to launch yourself there. Put a big pause on it. Shoots it by.
Lovely slow motion action replay of that on Costa's face, wide eye, and you could see his eyes light up as he knew he'd gone the right way. Good height for him, palmed it away. Bruno Fernandes, what sort of penalty are we going to get here? Portugal lead 1-0, could go 2-0 up after 2 penalties apiece. They'll be in a really strong position to reach the quarterfinals. Going to be a short run-up from Bruno Fernandes. Going to try and beat Jan Oblak. Here he comes, sends him the wrong way. Oblak stood still, he was going left, he stopped the dive, but by then the ball was in the bottom corner. That is a brilliant penalty.
It is. I mean, it's still huge, the pressure, but a little bit less pressure if you've already scored one and they've missed two. It's a lovely position for him there. Takes it and he is as calm as anyone in here.
Right, if Verbic misses this penalty, then the next one for Portugal could win the tie just like that. So this is crucial for Slovenia, who've been brilliant tonight. Šeško had the chance to win them the game near the end of the game. Verbic, though, has to try and find a way past Diogo Costa. They've not been able to do that in the shootout. Hands on his hips, he waits. He runs towards the ball. Oh, and Costa's denied him again. He's saved 3 out of 3. He's unbeatable in the shootout. That wasn't a good penalty. It was too close to him. And it feels like Slovenian
Oh, it's a tough one. I think there may have been a wee bit of a slip just as soon as he comes up to it. I'm checking to see if he's off the line again. No, he knows what he's doing. That is a brilliant save. He is reading every single one of them. But also, he's leaving the trailing foot on the line. Classic goalkeeping.
Right, Bernardo Silva being very careful with the penalty spot here, just treading it down. Both sets of subs, arm in arm, lined across the touchline. The Portuguese subs ready to go. If Bernardo Silva sticks this away, they're in the quarterfinals. They'll be playing France on Friday. He won't take too long over this. Here's Bernardo Silva! He scores! Portugal are through! Redemption for Cristiano Ronaldo. Jan Oblak couldn't make the saves in the shootout. And Diogo Costa, Portugal's keeper, absolutely sensational. And he's disappeared beneath a mountain of his teammates in those red shirts of Portugal. Cristiano Ronaldo is last there to join in the celebrations. There'll be tears again for him now, but there'll be tears of joy. Heartbreaking for Slovenia. They were superb tonight, but when it came to the crunch in the shootout, they couldn't beat Diogo Costa. Portugal win 3-0 on penalties, and they're through to the quarterfinals. Pat Nevin.
They are through to the quarterfinals, and they're a real quality penalty kick. You've got to give them that. What an extraordinary night. You know, the East team had fantastic chances, as you know, near the end. You've got to feel very, very sorry for the Slovenians. The battling qualities they had tonight. Good quality defending as well. The work rate of the two strikers was amazing. Maybe it lacked a little bit of quality to create things from the midfield. But against the players you've got, world-class players throughout that Portuguese side, to keep them at bay for 120 minutes was fantastic. But when you need to be strong, it's the big moments you make. The right decisions. And right at the end there, they decided to let Cristiano Ronaldo go first with the penalty kicks. Correct call. And then you've got Bruno Fernandes second. And then, of course, Silva at the end there. It's easy for him at that point in time. It was a really exciting night. It was a really atmospheric night. Yeah. What a brilliant night to be in this stadium.
Brilliant night of football. Incredible drama. No goals in 120 minutes. And you can see the relief seeping out of Cristiano Ronaldo right now. His teammates coming up to hug him. He's arm in arm with Diogo Costa and saying thank you very much indeed. But he did show bottle. It was a fabulous penalty to beat Jan Oblak. And it's the classic contrast mark inside the stadium. Red, green, gold, away to the left, having a party. Portuguese players celebrating with the fans, and the poor old Slovenians dragging themselves dejectedly to thank their amazing support this evening. And Benjamin Šeško, my eyes turned to him, 21-year-old,